Or whatever act it is, to replace the Sedition Act. We are not going to accept which is all widely packaged version of the Internal Security Act. And we're not going to accept the amendments to the Evidence Act, which basically makes all the wireless providers guilty for whatever is being published by its internet users. So ladies and gentlemen, it's very important because I am telling you, despite the promises, despite the fact that the Election Commission is going to allow overseas voters to cast their votes via the post. Why is it dangerous? Saya nak cerita hari ini, ya, kerana hari ini merupakan hari kami ahli-ahli parlimen Pakatan Rakyat berjumpa. Kita lalukan ke Rafizi Ramli, my comrade in arms, pengarah strategi keadilan. Saudara-saudari kena faham, ya. Please shake his hands. Please say hello to him. Because if you know, with these elections, we don't know how long he's going to be spending time in prison. I'm telling you. You know how devilish the government is? You promise transformation, but for the extension of the LRT project, a project that amounts to more than 1 billion ringgit, supposedly open tender, they decide and the Prime Minister interferes to give it to his crony, George Kent. What happens when Rafizi Ramli exposes the documents? They are marked as the Official Secrets Act, since the Rakyat cannot know anything that the government does, and he faces up to 2 years of imprisonment. And that's only on the George Kent expose. I have not even touched on the mafia as a result of the NSC mess that has engulfed us all. Jadi tentunya banyak risiko. Terus terang saya katakan, semasa kami ketika itu tahun 2003 di Kota London, Rafizi ini dia telah semasa bekerja di London menyerahkan sebahagian daripada gaji untuk Parti Keadilan Rakyat. Jadi tahun 2003 ketika itu bila kami bertemu, ya, saya pun tak jangka bahawa bila kita dah menang, ada Perdana Menteri yang kemungkinan mahu melaksanakan transformasi tapi masih lagi mengekalkan segala bentuk penipuan yang seperti dulu. Jadi ini amat menyedihkan kerana faham kita, projek LRT ini merupakan petanda test case yang terbesar sama ada Najib Tun Razak boleh mereformasikan negara ataupun tidak. Dan tak cukup dengan NFC, as we have tried our best to expose. Of course we try not to get sued lah in the process, but it's not easy because we are working in Malaysia, you know. But again, we welcome lawyers, we welcome free legal assistance. Please, Rafizi is waiting like that. He will list out the number of lawyers that have freely volunteered themselves. But the point here is not just Datuk Seri Shahrizad's family who has gotten so much from the country's wealth. It is also Datuk Jamaluddin Jarjis, seperti yang telah saya maklum dalam sistem mereda di Malaysia. Dan tidak lama lagi, 244 juta ringgit untuk sistem KLIA2. Siapa pengarah syarikat? Tak lain, tak bukan, anak duta besar Malaysia di Amerika Syarikat. Termasuk juga anak Datuk Raja Nongchi mendapat syarikat negotiated tender. Jadi pada saya begini, we are only seeing the tip of the iceberg. And that is why when people ask me, how would you make things different? How would you do it differently? I will say, bila kita bercakap tentang undang-undang di Malaysia, bila kita bercakap tentang tata cara pentadbiran di Malaysia, we have considerably good laws. What we don't have are good leaders. And this is what we must change. Not only am I mooting for for the National Harmony Act, we must create a bipartisan parliamentary committee and include the issue of national integration, the issue of racial relations. So at the end of the day, no member of parliament can walk away unscathed if they declare anyone to be hanged. Yes. We also have a Competition Act, but my biggest issue is for all leaders, whoever is made ministers in this country, if we were to take Putrajaya, please, none of our family members, sorry Habib, will be allowed to take or to receive any government projects whatsoever. That is our pledge. You have to kick me to it. Remember this. All of us here tonight, Malaysians, you have to do your bit. You have to keep all leaders to follow through with this basic principle. You will never see an end. If you do not put a stop, you will never see an end. And because of that, I'm telling you, it is not easy. But for me, this is something that we must accept. Dan terakhir, kerana saya telah dimaklumkan hanya boleh bercakap 10 minit. Biasalah, kita kena dengar juga. Ahli politik ni kena ikut disiplin. Yang disebut ya, hari ini, selepas pertemuan saya dengan Datuk Pandar. Datuk Pandar dah diganti dengan seorang lagi yang merupakan teman rapat Datuk Raja Mungci, Menteri Wilayah. So, KLMPs are not looking forward to it. But, you know, by the grace of God, I actually chanced upon my former returning officer in 08, who I swear didn't smile one bit when he announced my win at 2 in the morning. Okay? So, saya suspect dia tak apalah, mungkin dia sedih. Hari itu mungkin dia sakit. Kita ambil secara baiklah kan? So, saya jumpa, saya kata, lepas ni, returning officer. Tak mahu sebut nama lah. Lepas ni, jaga lembah pantai lagi ke? Kan, maybe, you know, for me, whatever it is, you have to be nice to the people. That's how we are taught, even though we are of different political backgrounds. Jawab, ya? Jawab returning officer saya tahun 2008. Jawabnya, tidak. Kalau saya jadi ROYB lembah pantai, YB tak akan menang lagi. And I thought it was a joke. It was a bad joke lah. But I really thought it was a joke. So saya tanya, are you serious? Dia pandang saya. Saya harus nyaput lepas ni. So I said, okay, that's the sort of arrogance. The fact that it leaves room for people to really suspect rigging will still take place. Pak Samad, saya geram betul tadi tu. No, can you imagine dahlah cakap SPR akan melaksanakan reformasi. SPR sudah melaksanakan semua tuntutan bersih. Tapi jumpa dengan returning officer yang akan menjadi returning officer lagi. Kalau saya jadi kat lembah pantai, YB takkan menang lagi. You see? So, for me, it's a rude awakening. I will make sure I write to the election commission and I expose this conversation because mana tahu lagi semua returning officer yang ada. You suka ke, tak suka ke parti itu, kerjanya kena objektif, kena professional. And this is exactly why Malaysia is in ruins today. Kerana dah lama. Mulia Raja Saleh bersama datang juga hari ini, alhamdulillah. Okay. The secret to my success, in-laws. It's not about getting the right parents. It's not about getting the right parents. It's like getting the right in-laws. Okay, jadi saya akhiri untuk menyatakan, apapun kita perlu bekerja keras. Saya mohon bersama-sama untuk menyelamatkan Malaysia. Saya gusar sebenarnya. Yes, I was joking, but I am only half joking because for me, the fact that he said that it was shocking. You know, we have so many institutions, unless we forget. The last sentence that came from the Prime Minister is this. The last sentence. Ya benar, Akta Keselamatan dalam negeri telah dimansuhkan kerana tidak lagi menjadi alat politik buat kerajaan pusat. So if you allow not only BIC, the Election Commission, the Royal Malaysian Police Force and the MECC to be mere political tools of Barisan Nasional, then you will spell the end of Malaysia. But never mind, hadirin hadirat, we shall persevere, let's work hard and let us make sure every vote, everyone comes out to vote. Thank you very much. Wassalamualaikum.